Ms. Stone, and I teach in the Law Magnet alongside Ms. Vanderlinden and Mr. Smith. Here in the Law Magnet, we offer a multitude of classes that range from history and law classes to mock trial classes, teen court, trial procedures, and all of our Law Magnet students are assessed on three main standards: presentation, argumentation, and civic responsibility. And those three standards really make up the core of the Law Magnet. And that's something that makes us really unique, because those three standards are the standards that are applicable to not just the classroom, but real world. So all of our students in the Law Magnet have the opportunity to learn within the confines of the classroom walls, but then we also create opportunities for our students to step outside the classroom and go shadow lawyers and meet with lawyers and go to courthouses and get real hands-on opportunity in Arizona's law system. I personally teach U.S. history and law, teen court and peer mediation, and this year I started teaching a new class called Social Justice and Civic Responsibility, which is based off of the United Nations.
What is your name?
My name is Mr. Almuna.
And what class do you teach?
I teach automotive.
What is automotive all about?
So automotive is pretty much an introductory for you guys to learn how to do anything. Simple oil changes, tire rotations to turn apart engines, transmissions, suspension, pretty much anything you need to do to work on your car at home.
Could this be used to gain a career in automotive, like things like becoming a mechanic or?
Yeah, I have a lot of students that end up going on, continuing on in schooling and go to UTI or GCC or Gateway Community and get their associates in automotive and start with dealerships.
Hi, my name is Maisha Brown and I teach early childhood education here at South Mountain High School. I teach two sections. One is the beginning level section for 1-2s, which means the first semester they take 1 and the second semester they take 2. In that class, they learn about development of children all the way from prenatal to birth, all the way up to school age. They learn about social emotional development, cognitive development, approaches to learning, language and communication development, and physical development, which includes gross and fine motor skills. They learn how to work with children, they learn how to work with babies, and they learn how to work with toddlers. They also learn leadership skills, and they learn career opportunities that are out there for them in this field and any other field that they're interested in. One of the main things that we focus on is just being ready for interviews, being ready to get out there in the workforce, professional development. In this class, my 1-2s will work with preschoolers in the preschool here, and they will do a field trip off campus with other preschools. Now my 3-4s is a little different. They're a higher level of caliber in this class. That means they've already taken the 1-2. They have the opportunity to get a CPR and first aid free through this program. We do have a training and a class that is required of them for an assessment. They also have the opportunity to take what we call a mechanical baby home, so they can actually practice the skills they've learned on infancy. They do this for a weekend and they are graded on it. The baby actually cries, you have to change the diaper, you have to feed the baby, you have to burp the baby, you have to rock the baby. These are all things that developmentally you would have to do with a real baby. You have to hold the neck, you can't be rough with it. All those things the students will actually get points taken off of. They also have the opportunity to have outside individuals in the community to come and interview them. This is my 3-4 class, to come and interview them so they can practice their interviewing skills. These people also check their resumes and their cover letters. They also are provided a thank you letter. The community is actually provided a thank you letter after the interviews have taken place. The 3-4 class is also required to do community service. We do community service projects. They are graded on it because it is part of the CTSO assessment. They also are required to go and do a preschool practicum, which is for 6 to 8 weeks, where each of them go to the preschool in the local community and they teach a lesson plan. In the spring, they will also set up a preschool here on campus and invite community members to come and participate in a half-day preschool. Well, they will be running it as preschool directors, while the 1-2 class actually will have the opportunity to work with the preschoolers. That's all I can tell you about our class as of now. Thank you for being interested in early childhood education at South Mountain High School.
So the current project is we're going to start building some bridges with my engineering class. We're going to explore how civil engineers make bridge designs using some mechanical engineering principles. And one of the things we're going to use is a laser etcher that will burn some of the parts so that we can get them to the exact specifications. And part of the class is learning how to use the equipment that uses computers to perfectly cut and machine materials.
What we mostly focus on, this is the CNA program first year, so the nursing 1-2, and we mostly focus on medical terminology, which there's a lot to learn, and also anatomy and physiology. So we're going through all the systems of the bodies, like the respiratory system, the cardiovascular or heart system, the muscular system, the skin, all the organs. We're going to go through all of that system.
In this class, they learn the skills and abilities that usual nurses would have in a hospital. And now, here's Leanna Evans with her view on Nursing 1-2.
The best part about my nursing class would have to be the hands-on experience that I get every day and the amount of learning and amount of tools I get to apply in my everyday experience and when I walk into the classroom. Are really endless, and I like to keep my projects very open so that way students can take it a different direction if that's what they want to do. So if a student has a different idea, I'm all about it. Let's roll with it. So it's really open. I actually was a drawing and painting teacher first, so ceramics has just become my passion this year. I didn't ever think I would be a ceramics teacher, and I'm so happy that I am because it's my favorite and I never will go back. Kids are so good. Like, they tell you at the very beginning that the kids are amazing, but every single class it shows through. Like, my kids are amazing, the teachers are amazing, the administration is amazing. I couldn't have asked for a better school to be at.
Hello, my name is Miss Jankowski, and I teach video broadcast and yearbook at South Mountain High School. This is my classroom. My amazing student, Kyrie Ware, is making the documentary that you are watching right now. So he didn't have a chance to tape me or have the option to be able to talk about my classes. So I'm going to get you caught up right now. In the communications department, we have three strands of classes. We have print, we have video, and we have audio production. If you're interested in taking any of those classes, please come and see myself, Ms. Montgomery, or Mr. Carter, which is one of the football coaches that you all know so well. Please come and check us out. Check out our facilities, check out our backgrounds, check out our classes. Come and talk to us. We want you in our classes if you are serious about being an amazing student, like we hope and know you are, and if you're serious about doing anything with sound production, with video, even DIY, YouTube stuff, green screens, filmmaking, or if you're interested in doing anything with print or yearbook, please come and check us out, talk to us, and get signed up for classes next year. We really want to know you and get you in our department. Have a great day.
Hi, my name is Susan Griffin, and I'm one of the dance teachers in the Conservatory Dance Program in the Media and Arts Academy here at South Mountain. Here in the Conservatory, we like to train students who are interested perhaps in going on and studying dance at the college level, or perhaps pursuing a career in dance. But we don't only serve those students. A lot of what you get in dance here, you can apply to all kinds of careers. We emphasize the creative aspects of dance, though you do get training in technique as well. We study modern, jazz, and ballet, and we do a lot with composition and choreography. All of our students learn how to choreograph and choreograph pieces that are performed on our concerts. We have both fall and spring concerts. Students have a lot of fun in the program, but it also is an academic program. You learn about dance history, you learn about theory, you learn about anatomy. So come join us. Come and dance with us here in the Conservatory Dance Program.
I'm Mr. Rogers, and I am the construction technology teacher here at South Mountain High School. Have you ever wanted to build things? Have you ever wanted to go ahead and possibly build a chair, a table? How about a bench? Or even possibly a small house or a shed? What about the use of power tools, hand tools? Have you ever really wanted to go ahead and learn how to go ahead and use them in a proper manner? Come join us. We offer three different types of classes. We offer geometry and construction, construction 3-4, and an internship. The geometry and construction class is a combination where you will be taught geometry and get a credit in geometry your sophomore year and be taught the concepts of geometry, and then you will actually apply them in the construction side of the classroom. It's a real world application of applying your math skills. Construction 3-4, it is a continuation of the geometry and construction 1-2. And then the internship is a possibility of working in a company your senior year, and hopefully which will lead into employment after high school.
I'm Ken Gulliford. I'm an instructor here in the aerospace area for the Aerospace and Engineering Academies, and I'm here to tell you about the courses that we've got available and what you can do with those courses. So, as a freshman, you would come into aerospace science, and that is the first course that you learn, and that is the prerequisite course for the remaining courses, which would be for your sophomore, junior, and senior year. So as you move along out of aerospace science, then you may select the area that you want to be in. Some people like to go for the pilot series, where you can be a pilot at the end when you're a senior, you fly airplanes and get your pilot's license. And if you do that, then we recommend that you go through the airport management class or the human factors class in your sophomore year. And then in your junior year, you take ground school. It's an FAA course, and that gives you a government certificate that allows you to train on private pilots and a private aircraft. As a senior, you would be training to get that private pilot license. The courses that I also teach are aircraft maintenance training. So that would be aircraft maintenance training at the sophomore level, junior level, and senior level. And we can go through those, and you will be rated to take the test to be a A&P mechanic. That's all the courses that we've got. We do things here behind me. We've got our wind tunnel, which is about to become operational. And in the other room, we've got our simulator, which is a highly qualified simulator that allows you to practice flying when you're in your ground school and flight school training. Thank you.
is Harry Grissom. I head up the biotechnology program here at South Mountain High School. One of the things we're trying to achieve with this program is give the opportunity to students to be able to leave the program, go out in the field, and get a job at a biotech company. You don't need a four-year degree to do this. Just get through this program, which is actually a four-semester program. It'll equip you with everything you know.
In the Pharmacy 1-2 class, because it became an option here at South, and I thought it would be a great new thing to do. And I had the background, and I always liked pharmacy, and I felt like I was missing something in my life. So I decided, yeah, that sounded like something fun and new that I could do, and a change of pace for me and what I was doing here. This class changes the way I look at my students because it challenges me to teach them something different and teach in a different way than I've taught. Here I've used to teach theater, well, I still teach theater, but it also challenges me to teach them math and science in a different method and also get them involved in something that they'll actually be able to use after high school for their college prep as well. If this is a great base knowledge, either for the pharmacy tech program that they can take the knowledge that they learn here and then go out into the world and graduate and have a job, or that they'll at least have the basic knowledge and then they can go out into the medical field and go into college, and then they have that background information so that they can be better prepared for medical school, nursing, whatever that program that they'd like to do. They have that knowledge and they can be prepared.
My name is Scott Parks. I am the instructor of the SciTech Academy's Networking Technologies and Cybersecurity class. In this class, we get to explore about the meaning of network technologies and cybersecurity. We are learning about the who, how, and why of the tools and techniques used by drones, people, businesses, and even horses. We are learning how things work together to keep a computer network connected to the internet with what is called data integrity while preventing unauthorized access. At South Mountain, we have a bunch of stuff we are supposed to learn about computers, but it doesn't seem like work to the students. That's because it isn't only about knowing what the technology is, but that they can communicate from student to student and from student to teacher.